right. Question is, training the circus dumbbell, what kind of sets and reps? Train it with your other overhead, etc. Right now, I'm training overhead on Monday, which is log press and then a bunch of other crap. You know, mostly vertical pulling and pushing. And then on Friday, I do horizontal pulling and pushing. Then Saturday, I do my circus dumbbell work before my event. You don't have to do it that way, but that's how I'm doing it. And right now, I'm training it where I do like one or two sets, where I work up, where I clean each for 5 reps, and then I do one or two sets where I clean it once and press it for hopefully 8 to 10-ish or so. I don't think you should go under 5 reps training the circus dumbbell. I just had a conversation with a Steve Trippy, I like to call him Trippy, about this, and he agreed, and he hit a 190-pound circus dumbbell at 170, or like one, you know, pretty much body weight circus dumbbell. Because, you know, he's saying you need to hit the stabilizer muscles, which you don't when you overload it and go way too heavy. But the most important thing of the circus dumbbell is being able to get it in the correct position, having the mobility to do so. If your lats are too tight, you know, your shoulder's too tight, you can't get it back there, you're never going to get a good position to press it from. So that's the main thing. And another thing, Steve mentioned is your last rep, just kind of holding it overhead, and you know, because you have to be able to stabilize that dumbbell with one arm at the top is really important. And, you know, most people aren't, they don't fail in the circus dumbbell from a lack of strength. It's either from a lack of technique or because they can't stabilize it. So hit your rear delts really hard, work on getting that right rack position, hit it, you know, for 5 reps or more, and you know, just hold it at the top.